Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm your favorite YouTuber, Jordan Gold, and today I'm gonna give you a tutorial of an app called InShot. So InShot is an editing app that you can download on phone and it's kind of popular. And this is the part one of the tutorial. And on this part, I'll give you the tutorial for the photo and collage editing part. And part two is for video editing tutorial. So now let's just start the tutorial. And I also put the timestamps in the description below. Okay guys, in the front page, there's a create new video, photo, or collage. And down here, there's material. So it's like a filter or sticker kind of thing. And up here, there's a crown button. It's for premium. And also the setting buttons for settings. So now, let's go to the material first. We click see all. And in here, you can scroll down to see stickers. And well, mostly what we see right now is stickers. And there's the one that you have to pay for it. And there's also the one that is free. You just have to watch the app. So let's be just gonna watch the app. And it's downloaded. We can see the stickers and we have this all stickers. It's all installed. And now we go to the editing part. Okay guys, so after we were done with the video editing, now we go to the photo editing. So we just click this photo button. And here is the list of our photos. And also if you can't find your photos anywhere here, you can also click this recent and you can search all of your photos folder from here. And also if you want to take it from your gallery right away, you can click this and you can just go to your photos gallery. So now I'm just gonna pick this photos and down here there will be all of the tools that you can use to edit your video. And now we start from canvas. Here we click canvas. So in canvas, you can pick which ratio you want to apply to your photos. Like example, you want to edit it to upload it on Instagram, this ratio. And also maybe you want to make it for Twitter, Facebook, or even I think this wallpaper. And as we can see, there's white space in here because this photos doesn't match the ratio. And maybe if you want it to fit well and you want this white space to be here, you can click this to cover all of the space. You can also move it over with your finger and also pinch to zoom in. You can also do that and unpinch to unzoom it. And also if you want it to be nicer, maybe you can use this button. This button works for zoom in and zoom out. And also these two buttons next to it, if you want to move your picture like to go up or down. Example, up, down. And if you want to change it to the middle, you can do it with your finger. You can also do it with this button again, with this and this, and you're done like that. And now I'm gonna choose this ratio, okay? And if you're done, you can just click done. And next to canvas, there's filter. So in filter, there's obviously filter to make your picture look better. Sample this. It's kind of nice. And when you find the right filter for your photos and you want to change how much it applies to your photos, you can just click the filter again. You can also edit how much you want it to apply to your video. And you can check the before and after by clicking this button. So this is before and this is after. And when you think it's done, you can just click done. And also here there's effect. So in effect, there's an effect that like glitch. You can also edit how much the effect you wanted to apply to your video. Example this. You can also do this by clicking the effects again. Like that. And say the before and after. And there's a lot of effects you can find here. Mirror like that. So and also you can do like this maybe if you want it. And now we're going to adjust and there's all of this filter, but now we click this checklist button first, save it. And next to filter there's adjust, so we can go to adjust by click adjust in here or from filter if you want it, but I'm just gonna click it from here. And in adjust there's lightness, contrast, warmth, tint, saturation, HSL, which is a hue, saturation, and luminance, which you can edit the color of your photos. I think this is for yellow and green. This is the hue and saturation. I'm going to separate it. Okay. Maybe minus one. Oh, yeah. Let's just saturate it. And You can check the before and after by clicking this. Okay, and click done when you're done. And there's fade if you want the color of your picture to fade like that. But it's kind of cool also if you like that kind of vibe. There's highlight if you want to make your picture get more highlight. That means the white of your picture, like the bright one, will be more brighter like that. And also shadow. So you want the shadow to be more boom by clicking this, making this minus. Or you can do this to not see any shadow, to see less of shadow. Okay, and there's color. You can edit the highlight and shadow of your color by changing the color, and you can edit how much you want it to apply. You can also click this if you want to cancel it. Click done. And there's hue. That's for the color of your picture. And there's thickness if you want to make it like kind of black, and thickness if you want it to be black in the tip of these four places, like example like this, and see the before and after. And there's sharpen if your photos is not sharpened enough, and also grain to make your photos grainy. Yeah, like that. And click done when you're done. And next to it, there's background. So in background, you can choose the background of your photos, like for this white spot. So before, the background was white, and now you can use your own photo's background like this and make it blur if you want it. And there's a different level of blur you can use, and also you can change the color if you want to use color one. And also you can edit your own color if you want it and if you can do it. There's also gradient down here that you can use. It's kind of cool. And you can also upload a picture, a custom picture, to be the background. Like example, you can just click this button and it will open your gallery. You can choose which picture you want it to be the background. Like example, I just gonna choose this, and it's blurry right now, but you can do this also. And you can also delete it if you want it by click this. And also if you don't want any background for the photos, you can do this. So we're just gonna use this background for now. And then we click done. And next to background, there's crop. To crop your picture, you can crop it as however you want, and also with a custom ratio if you want it. We're done. And next to crop, there's sticker. You can pick if you want to put any sticker on this picture. You can also buy it and also download it if you want it. This is the sticker that we just downloaded before, and you can put it next to it. Insert flower. And also this button work for flipping the picture. This to change the size and also make it like this. And also you can click this, and this will work for to edit the opacity of the sticker you want to apply it to. And maybe you want to apply for 70% only, you can do that like that. And when you're done, you can just click done, and this is the result for the sticker. And next to sticker, there's text. Can insert text in your video. I'm gonna write my Instagram tag, Jordan Coles. And in here, you can change the color of everything. First, the color of your text. If you want it to be white, you can do that. And down here, there's the background for your text. You can choose each one of it. There's a lot. You can also edit the border. If you want to give your text a border with any color you want, you can also edit how thick the border you want it to apply to your text. And you can also delete the border by clicking this. And you can also click shadow, so you can turn it off or on. So this X and Y button work for to locate the shadow of your text. Simply move it to this place so you can see it clearly. So X work for if you want to move it to right or left, and Y to up or down like that. And this percent thing work for how much you want it to apply, like the shadow. You want it to be blurry, or you want it not blur at all. It's kind of nice. And there's label. Label is the background for the text if you want it. And in here, there's a multiple label you can use. And you can also change the color. Or if you don't want any label at all, you can just click this. And maybe if you choose a label, example this one, and you want to change the opacity, you can just click opacity and change the opacity. But it also works for the text, not only for the label. So don't capacity of our text, we give 100%. And if you click this button, this will be the font section. And in the section, you can change your font. This. You can also download it or buy font if you want it. I'm just gonna go back with Caviar Dream. And this will be the editing for the text. Like you want it to be how big the text will be. The size, I mean. And the space between each text. This also works for to give a space if you have a multiple line in your text. And it can change the location if you have like a paragraph like that. And when you're done, you can click done, but I'm gonna relocate X first. I'm gonna put it in here. And anyway, this is not my picture, so it's just for example. And we click done when we're done. And next to text, there's frame. You can click frame. And this frame is work for to give a frame to your picture, not the background. And you can also edit in which location you want the picture to apply. Just move it with your hand like that. And you can also make it more zoom, bigger or smaller. And you can also like unpinch your picture and also make it zoom like that. But if you don't want to give any frame, you can just click this and click done. Done. And there's a rotate button. If you want to rotate your picture, you can rotate or maybe flip your picture. Rotate it like this, or you can change the angle. Okay, and also zoom in or zoom out. Just make it normal, and when you're done, click done. And this is all for the editing of the photo part. And if you want to save it, you can just click save, and your picture is saved like this. That's nice, isn't it? With all of the cool features. You can also share your picture immediately by click other, or maybe in the socials you can find here. And when you're done, you can click home. And now, after we're done with the photo, now we go to college. So we just click it, and you can choose all of the photos you want to insert. So you can choose 1 to 9 photos to create a beautiful college. You can choose the picture. So I'm gonna choose this picture, and also this. And this is the layout that are applied right now. And you can also click this to switch the placement. And also, if you want to choose your own layout, you can do that by click layout. And here will be all of the layout that are available, like this. And you can also edit the picture placement if you want to edit it or unzoom it. You can also swap picture with another picture and edit the size and also the placement of the photos. You can crop it, rotate it, flip it, delete it if you want it though, and swap. We're trying to swap with this one like this. You can also edit the border. So this will be the border between each photos. This is the border between this side. This is to make it like kind of brownie, not really sharp in the picture, like that. Yeah, and I think it's kind of nice. And when you're done, you can just click the checklist button, but you can also edit this, and also you can add a picture if you want it. Like example, this. And there are 6 picture. You want to add this, there will be 7 picture. You can also edit the picture again. And also when you're done, you can just click checklist done. And when you click done, it's not saved yet. It's just for all of the border things like that. And now there's gallery layout, border canvas, filter background, sticker, text frame, and rotate in this section. So first, gallery. If you want to switch the photos or add photos or edit the layout and border again. And layout, if you want to change the layout, like the same gallery layout border, you can click it if you want to change any part of it. And this is canvas to add the ratio, and click done. And filter, I know you all know filter. You can choose which photo you want to change the effects and filter or adjust. And when you're done, you click done. And also you can change the background with a blur picture. any picture you choose, or you can also you can choose picture from your gallery. Like example, we're gonna choose another picture, and I think this one kind of nice. You can also edit the blur. Also, you can choose color or gradient if you want it. And if you want to delete the picture, you can just click delete. And we're just gonna choose this background. It's kind of pretty, I guess. And this there is sticker. Again, we already know about sticker. You can add, maybe I'm gonna just put one of it here. Yeah, done. And there's text. If you want to add text, hey, this will be all of the color things. You can also make the color gradient and change the text font, and also the size, space between text and space between lines if you have one, and the location. And there's frame. If you want to frame your picture like that, I mean, it's kind of cool if you do it like this, but I don't really like it, so I just click that to cancel it, and you can rotate. Well, you rotate this picture only. If you want to rotate the other picture, you can do it to each picture, like that. And when you're done, you can just click save, and it will be saved to your gallery. And we're done, we just click home. And I think that's it for the tutorial. And also, maybe you want to go to the settings stuff. We just do it, maybe in case any of you want it. So in here, there's InShot Pro. You can change the language, add text, restore purchases, send feedbacks to them, follow them on Instagram, invite friends, and also read the privacy policy, terms of knowledge, and also see the app version. Just click back and this crown thing if you want to subscribe to InShot Pro. Okay, so I think that's all for the editing part. Okay guys, this is the end of the part 1 tutorial. I hope this is helpful, and I also suggest you to watch the part 2. You can click it on here or in the description below. So this is the end of the video. I hope this is helpful, and I hope you love it too. Don't forget to click the subscribe button, thumbs up button, and comment down below, and also share this video to all of your friends and family and social media. Thank you for watching. I love you all. God bless you all. Have a nice day, and peace.